To my channel. Today I'm going to show you Semaiya Upma. So if you like the recipe, please press the like button or the subscribe button. So let's start with the ingredients. For the ingredients we need, first we need the Semaiya, which is totally dry, and I have taken around one bowl of the Semaiya. Apart from that, I have taken there is a white oil, any kind of vegetable oil, water is as required. Here I have chopped potatoes. Potatoes are very, you know, small size. I have chopped it here. Yes, like this. You can see I have chopped in a such a small cube. Apart from that, we need onion, sliced onion, green chilies. Let's make it closer. Here I have taken chopped ginger, chopped tomatoes, one lime. Then green peas. Here I have taken for tarka, jeera, curry leaves, and this is a roasted, red chili. If you dry road chili, if you want, you can add the mustard seed also, but there's very much option. I'm just ignoring it. And for the masalas, we need turmeric, salt to taste, roasted cumin and coriander, roasted cumin and coriander powder, and this is the black salt. So let's start with the recipes. First, we have to heat the pan. Then we have to do the dry roast the all the Semaiya. Because first of all, Semaiyas are fully packaged food, and before everything we need to make it a dry roast. I prefer to dry roast and then pour the water, but if you want, you can first boil the Semaiya and then cook rest of the part. For me, I just dry roast it. If you want, you can dry roast even in the microwave. For the microwave, you will take in a flat plate or in a flat kind of any kind of utensils, because don't make the take the bowl or keep the all the Semaiya inside the bowl. So for the microwave, take a plate, microwave safe plate, then pour it, and around 200 degrees of centigrade, roasted around 1 to 1.5 minutes, but in between you have to stir it and take it out and stir it. So first we have to, if anyhow, dry roasted. If any kind of vehicle sounds or sounds are coming, please ignore. After dry roast, it will be looking like this, and almost it will be looking like, as I said, bhujia. But you can understand it's roasted, because due to the roasting, the color has been changed. Okay, let's heat the pan once more. Then add some vegetables. As the oil started heating, you'll understand. Then we will add all the tarka things. First of all, I'll add jeera, then curry leaves, and roasted dry red chili. Not roasted, it's dry red chili. If you want, you can add some chili flakes also, it's up to you. But here I have prepared this one. Another thing I forgot to mention you, another optional thing is that that's the asafoetida. Asafoetida, if you need, you can add, but I'm not using here, because in upmas, it's a semolina upma, wherever I don't prefer asafoetida over there. So here also I'm not using. If you want, you can even add asafoetida here. Yes, it started popping. As it will be started popping, then we will add rest of the green chilies. Just because I'm adding here red chilies and green chilies together, so I am not adding any other red chili powder or any other separate pungenting thing. If you want, you can add the red chilies also. Okay, after adding the green chilies, I want to add chopped onion. Let's start it. Just keep in mind that in this case, the flame should be medium. Otherwise, all the green chilies and onion will be burnt. So make sure it should, the flame should be medium. See, the colors of the just a minute. The colors of the onions are getting changed. In this stage, I'm going to add chopped potatoes. If you want, you can add some other vegetables like capsicums or carrots, French beans. Now the green peas, or else you can add the sweet corn, whatever you want. Well, I'm preferring this one because these things are now available at my home, so I'm showing it. But capsicum was there, but I didn't add it. But I told you it's for extremely optional. Now fry it, and then I'm adding the chopped ginger. Fry it, not too much, little bit of. just start it. In this stage, if you want, you can make your flame high, because onions are already fried. So in this stage, you can add. Now I will add the chopped tomatoes. I have taken only little amount of half of the tomatoes, just for a tangy taste, not too much. After adding the tomatoes, I am going to add the salt as required. Then very little amount of turmeric, just for a little color, nothing else. Then stir it. Rest of the masalas we will add later on. Before, as you are going to bring it out of the flame, that time we are going to add the roasted cumin and coriander powder and the black salt with the lime. Okay. Now it's time to add the roasted semaiya in this dish. Now I'm adding all the semaiyas here. Now stir it. Another thing I want to mention here, as you are adding the semaiya here, so please make sure your flame should be in a low or a medium low flame, because we actually don't prefer to burn semaiya in these things. Though these are roasted, but still it needs to be in a low flame. So please make sure, and you have to, and again, just stir it properly and flip. Just stir it and flip. Now time to add some water. For the water, the quantity of the semaiya and water should be same. So I have taken one bowl of semaiya. So I am taking one bowl of water. This I am going to add there, because semaiya is very soft thing, so it needs only little bit of hydration. So after adding this water, it will be softer very quickly. So just add the water. Here I am adding the water, just to perfect. You can see the quantity. Excuse me. After adding this water, you have to make it flat from everywhere. Yes. After adding the water and flatten it, I'm going to cover it for at least for 1 to 1.5 minute. After that, it will be softened and your poha will be ready. In between, you have to open the lid and check whether the semaiyas are becoming soft or not. Then I'm going to add here. So as you will see, the semaiya is becoming soft and water has been soaked. So in this stage, I'm going to add some lime juice. It's very tasty. Some black salt. This is optional. How much salt you have added over previously, this quantity depends on that. Then some coriander leaves. If I forgot to mention about this, please forgive me, because this is very emergency, or not emergency, it's very important part of this any kind of upma. And very little amount of this powder is a roasted coriander and cumin powder, and it brings such a wonderful taste of, and it brings you a chaat kind of taste or the aroma. So please stir it constantly like this. Yes, some black salts are there, so you have to stir it. Semaiya upma is ready. You can enjoy it at your breakfast or your any kind of office or anywhere. So if you like it, please press the like button or subscribe my channel. Bye.